Okay friends, in this video we will cover how to edit our post. Like a, you can say hello I post, and I will add a column here, edit the post with Modal, Bootstrap Modal. So for that, go to your favorite editor, open welcome blade. Here you will see your post. Okay, here is your post. Inside this you have an anchor tag. Here you can see edit, and anchor tag you will fill with the ID. I already have a code for our Modal, Bootstrap Modal. You can copy this and add in your anchor tag. And this is your Modal. Copy this Modal and paste anywhere you can put this. Okay, just loop of your post loop. Okay, under your post loop, paste here. Okay friends, I will try to cover this topic with very easy way. Just pay attention. Now you don't need this. Go to edit your browser, refresh. You will see you have a edit link, and click, you have a Modal. But you can see I can open Modal, but not particular post. For that you have to pass post ID to open that particular data. For that, first of all you will pass here post ID to make it separate, post.id. and here target is this ID. You will change this ID to with post.id. okay, save it, reload. Now try to open any randomly. Okay, I have an error. Error is, you can see expression is not get by your VueJS. So for that you have to change it, this semicolon. That's it, reload. Now try to open Modal, and here is your Modal. You need to change your data, post dot content. Save it, reload. Now open any post. Like I want to see this content in Modal, so open it, edit. You can see here is. Okay, this is very easy. Just change the edit post, your title. This is. Now you need text area, and you need to update this by your functionality of Laravel. So for that you will change it, text area, and you need to make it VModal. Name it anything. I name it updated content, and you have to declare in your app.js. app.js with your content you will put here. That's it. Okay, now I have an error. You need comma. Okay, reload, build successful. Okay, I think I mistake something. VModal. Okay, it's test area. Reload. Now you can see its text area, but it's empty, because it's by default is empty. So for that you have to fill this with data of that content which we selected. For that, I will create one more link to show you what I try to do. Like post one, I need particular post by ID. So for that, go to your route web.php, create anywhere new route, get post ID function ID pass. Here you will say post data app post, where post is a model here, where ID equal to this ID and get. So you can return this. So here is the data, and post one, post two, this is right. But I need only content to show in my text area model. Okay, you need to show there. For that, you will say next line echo p data index array and content. Save it, reload. Here is your data. Now you can change ID. That's fine. One, that's fine. Okay, now you need to display here. For that, go to welcome.php welcome blade, a class form control. Save it. I need to fill this by function. So for that, if someone click on this, I need to call a new function. So for that, here you will say click open model and pass a ID. That's it. And inside the method, you can create here open model ID. Here alert just ID. Okay, that's it. Save it, reload. If I click here and you have to pass this ID, let me show you console. First of all, console.log. If model reload, open inspect element. Okay, update content not defined. Here we have a error actually. Update content, let me find. Okay, here is the update content. This model, but I already define it, so that is not error. Okay, I think it's a not a clear cache. Let me open this new window and paste here. Let me log in again. Mo, you can log in with any ID. Go to Laravel welcome blade, inspect element, console. Okay, no error. Just click here, and now you have a ID received here, 35. Okay, now you need to pass the data here. You have to you can copy this, actually this copy and paste here. Here you can say post id get and fill this update content with data, which coming from is coming from this one. Okay, and this id, this is id. Okay, that's it. Okay, now it will update and it will show, let me change the spelling actually, content copy in spelling here also and here also. Okay, save it, reload. Now we should see our data here because I paused already that data in here. Now you need a save button here to pass id and pass this data to your controller. So for that, here you will change, first of all view change and copy a button, make a new button, call it success class and save changes. That's fine. And you will say click new function update post with post id. You will pass here post id. It will go to new method. We will create here update post id and id received by parameter, and here you just need to update new post, so you can copy this. We will change what we need. We need new route, update post with this id. Okay, this id we will say changes saved successfully, everything rest is fine. Here content, you will change it update content. Here also update content, save it. Now you need this name of route. Here you will create route get, no get, here you should use post, and your controller name posts controller and update post, save it. Now open your controller, post controller. Here you will create new function, public function update post. Here you will receive two things, one is id, second is request data. Request, that's fine. Okay, now you will create a new variable update post, new variable and db table name post where id is id, this id, and update, update will be with array, so you should use this bracket. Inside this you will put content, content fill with request your update content, updated content, this one you will use here, that's fine. Now you will say if update post is done, then just will receive this old data like this, save it. That's it. I think we complete everything. Now we will try to edit my post. Hello to hi. Save change. Okay. Changes is not saved. Let me see. I think we have a 404 error. Hi. Save changes and yes. Our route is not found. Which route? Okay, you have to put this ID. So which we receiving here? Okay, reload. Change my data. Hello to hi. Save change. And here is, you can see your data is changed. That's it. For now it's working on all one, because I did not add check user ID, but I will add after some time. Okay, so I can change this also, save. So that's it. The actually pending, we will cover in the next video. We will check only which post by me, that only I can edit, not other one. Okay, this is close, this is save. That's it. Okay, this is a error because we are not getting the any changes. Then we will show here, add some validation type, save it. Now you have a save it. Now if I want to change this line with image, nice pose with yoga, save changes. And here is your save changes. That's fine. So see you in the next video. Thank you.